since I had started some stage with poetry, there are two things that are still relevant to it, and then I'll put it away and I promise not to return to poetry or short stories, although I'm not promising not to return some other writing. I said my wife always calls me chemist. Question, what do I call her? And I call her a name that I'm sure no other woman has ever been called, which is a pretty rash statement to make because you think almost anything in in love or affection must have happened anywhere between a billion times to at least a few thousand times. And yet, I don't think so. And it's based on a poem, and it's based on a poem by Wallace Stevens, one of the, you know, many people call him one of perhaps the three greatest 20th century poets of of America. And strangely enough, in 2 days, we're going to Wallace Stevens conference at Oxford, which is about something like 50 years of Wallace Stevens, the anniversary of 50 years of his arrival. I don't mean physical arrival, but sort of real arrival over in Europe, because a complicated poet in terms of being translated and so on here. And I am undoubtedly the only organic chemist in the world. You see, I make all these promotional automythological statements that have really no statistical basis, but probably the only organic chemist who has published not once but 5 times in the Wallace Stevens Journal. And now, why did I do that? Because Diane Middlebrook, my wife, that was her first book, was on Wallace Stevens. Her PhD thesis at Yale was on Stevens and Whitman. So I audited courses of hers during our sort of pre-marriage relationship, which my father, a Balkanese, intelligent man of Balkanese, always referred to as concubinage. It's what he thought our relationship was before we got married, before his death. And here are two poems, Wallace Stevens' poem that I wrote during this emotional catharsis when my now wife had left me before we were wives. And there are 4 poems here I've written, more of these, about Wallace Stevens, which are always based on a Wallace Stevens epigraph. Now, this is a poem, it was probably the first revenge poem I wrote based on Wallace Stevens. I wrote others earlier, revenge against my wife's abandonment of me. But this was from a poem called Good Man, Bad Woman. That's sort of the title, no wonder I picked that. And the line of Wallace Stevens that I then selected, which is both a quote and the title of my poem, is pure scientist, you look with nice aplomb, A-P-L-O-M-B. So pure scientist, you look with nice aplomb. And it's typical Stevensian title where his titles seemingly have very little to do with the subject matter. The Emperor of Ice Cream, or Peter Quince at the clavier deals with Susanna and the Elders. And you think, what does Peter Quince playing the clavier has to do with Susanna and the Elders, a biblical story, or things like that. So that's related to this. So what I wrote is just a short 4-stanza poem.